Hey, for Bass, it's Freely Banana Girl here. Welcome to another episode. So I've got like a lovely background here. I've got the old mattress, got the computer. It's a little bit of a mess, but the lighting is kind of coming in the best here. It's been going in and out and crazy. So hopefully it holds out for this video. So today's video is about All About That Bass, the song by Meghan Trainor. You must have heard it before. It's been playing over and over and over in my head the last couple of days. Because you know I'm all about the bass, no treble. You know that song? And that specifically means bass as in I'm all about the junk in the trunk, not the treble, not the skinny bitches. That's what I'm going to get into today. You know, there's a lot of controversy about it being skinny shaming, and I have to agree. Okay, let's get into the lyrics here. Let's get straight into the skinny bitch lyrics. Go ahead. So, I'm bringing booty back. This is what Meghan says. I'm bringing booty back. Go ahead and tell them skinny bitches that. No, I'm just playing. So, look. Tell them skinny bitches that. That's pretty self-explanatory. That's pretty, like, forward. And then she says, no, I'm just playing. No, you're not just playing, Meghan. Stand up for your own opinion. Own your own opinion. That's what you meant. The reason she's put, no, I'm just playing, is so she doesn't get too much heat off the skinny bitches. Well, there's a skinny bitch here, and the skinny bitch is going to give you some heat today. This is an irresponsible song. It's meant to be, like, body positive, but it's actually putting down one group of women to, you know, raise up another, which is just ridiculous. You know, putting down the skinny bitches here, so those who are overweight can feel good about themselves. That's not okay. That is not body positive. And then it goes on to say, you know, there's other little, like, jabs in there to skinny bitches. There's other jabs here and there. And when I say skinny bitches, I mean skinnier women, okay? But she's calling them bitches. You know, I won't be no stick figure silicone Barbie doll. So if that's where what you're into, then go ahead and move along. Meghan, that's nasty. That is unnecessarily nasty. You know, just insulting other women like that to try and get your message across, to me, just shows like a lack of integrity. It really does. And some of you might be like, oh, Freely, you fat shame people, you hate fat people, and you do this and that. And no, if you don't know the difference yet, then I don't, you've been living under a rock. I actually care enough about people. I educate people. I don't hate on people. You don't see me saying you're a fat, ugly bitch, you're a slob, you're a blah, blah. No, you know, because I don't actually think that. I know that people are in a situation that is challenging for them, and they need to come out of that. So I educate them, I show them how. I'm like, hey, you can get from there where you are now to over here, and this is how you do it. Not you're just some skinny bitch, or you're just some fat bitch who's useless. So there's a lot of negativity in this song, and it's disappointing, and it feels like that we're going to get more and more of these songs because more of the population is getting overweight. You know, over 70% of the population is overweight. So more, these songs are going to get more and more and more support. And you might be saying, oh, you know, she just wants people to feel good about themselves. That's fine. But you don't need to call other women skinny bitches. You don't need to insult other women in order to help other women feel good about themselves. And there's a danger in helping people who are overweight, over their optimal weight, in, you know, feeling good about themselves to the point of denial. Okay, I'm all about women feeling good about themselves. I'm completely all about that. I love that. I love seeing women feel good about themselves. And let's be realistic, that includes nourishing your body, looking after your temple with the best possible foods, the best possible nutrition. It's about keeping your body at a healthy weight. That is what love, self-love is about. How can you love yourself when you're polluting your body? When you're polluting your body, when you're being mean to your body. You can't love yourself when you're being mean to yourself. That is just an oxymoron. And that's what I promote. Be good to yourself by actually loving yourself with the ideal nutrition, you know, exercising and living a healthy lifestyle. That's true love, my friends. That is absolute love. Let's not be in denial about our situation. We have to get real and say, look, I have fat. Don't say I'm fat. Don't identify with that fat and that become your identity and you just own that and you never change. Say you have fat. You have this temporary fat that you need to lose. Okay, let's establish that. Let's get real. Let's have that awareness and go, okay, this is where I'm at. That's great. That's the first step. And now to where you have to go. And I have all that information on my channel. It's all there. It's ready for you to step up. make it happen. Quit the yapping and make it happen. And I love nothing more than seeing people who have fat, you know, lose fat and get healthy. And that's the thing, focus on getting healthy, don't focus on the fat. The fat will go. You may have fat now, but in time it will go. You need to be patient, keep focusing on getting healthier, fitter, and the leanness will come. Your body will find its happy place. But you gotta make that ball roll. If that ball is not rolling, if you're like, I love myself and I'm obese, I'm overweight, I'm morbidly obese, then are you going to change? Are you going to take those steps to really nourish yourself? Or are you going to be like, well, you know, everyone around me is overweight, they're obese, the family's obese, so I don't need to change? Because the reality is a lot of people are like that. You may not be like that, and that's great, but make it happen and be true to yourself, true to that, what you've been saying about loving yourself, and actually start loving yourself by looking after yourself. That's what I'm saying. That is my big message today. So I hope that comes through loud and clear. And I want to see you succeed. All the information here is on my channel. Step up, do a 30-day raw till four challenge. Do a 30-day high carb raw vegan, high carb vegan, whatever you like. Do that challenge. Get the ball rolling. So please put in the comments below, are you ready to get the ball rolling and really, truly start loving yourself? Tell me.